फ्रेंड्स, मायसेल्फ मिनल देशपांडे फ्रॉम गोकुल एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज एचएल हाई स्कूल इंग्लिश मीडियम ओझर टाउनशिप. वी आर लर्निंग हिस्ट्री एंड सिविक्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 6 महाराष्ट्र स्टेट बोर्ड इंग्लिश मीडियम सिलेबस. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ लेसन नंबर 9 एंशियंट किंगडम्स ऑफ द साउथ. And in our previous video, we took information of some points. 9.1, the Cher, Pandya and Chola dynasties. 9.2, the Satavahana dynasty. And 9.3, the Vakatika dynasty. Students, in today's video, we are going to our next points. 9.4, the Chalukya dynasty. 9.5, the Pallava dynasty. And 9.6, the Rashtrakut dynasty. Students, 9.4, the Chalukya dynasty. The Chalukya dynasty in Karnataka was a powerful one. And the kingdoms of Kadamba, Kalachari had become powerful after the decline of the Vakatikas. But the Chalukya kings established their dominance over all of them. Dominance means they being in a position of their power or authority. Now, Chalukya kings established their own power or they took own authority. And Pulkeshi first established the rule of the Chalukya dynasty in 6th century CE. Pulkeshi first. His capital was Badami, which was earlier called Vatapi. The Chalukya king Pulkeshi II had successfully repulsed Emperor Harshvardhan's invasion. Repulsed means to repel or to drive back. Okay, means he successfully faced to the invasion of Emperor Harshvardhan's. The famous temple at Badami, Ahihole and Pattadakal were built during the Chalukya period. Okay, students, there is example of Ahihole also and Pattadakal also. Okay, now 9.5, the Pallava dynasty. The Pallavas were also very powerful dynasty in South India. See students, first I told you about Chalukya dynasty and now I'm telling about the Pallava dynasty, and that was also a very powerful dynasty in South India. Kanchipuram in Tamil Nadu was their capital. Tamil Nadu, okay? Kanchipuram was the capital. Mahendra Varman was an able Pallava ruler. He expanded the Pallava kingdom. He was also a playwright. Playwright means a writer or a creator of the theatrical plays. His son Narasimha Varman repulsed the attack on his kingdom by the Chalukya king Pulkeshi II. The famous Ratha temples of Mahabalipuram were sculpted during his regime. Sculpted means to form. These temples have been sculpted in single rock. Okay, that whole temple is built, or we can say that was constructed in single rock. The Pallavas had a powerful and well-equipped navy. During this period, India came in a close contact with the countries of Southeast Asia, and internal and foreign trade flourished. See students, that time internal and foreign trade was flourished because of them. Yuan Shuang had visited Kanchi and recorded that people of all religions received tolerance and just treatment under the rule of the Pallava kings. When Yuan Shuang visited to Kanchi and he saw that there was a great treatment given by the Pallava kings to the people. Okay, now 9.6, the Rashtrakut dynasty. Rashtrakuta dynasty. At the height of their power, the dominion of the Rashtrakuta dynasty extended from the Vindhya mountains up to Kanyakumari in the south. See students, dominion means a kingdom which governed territory. Kingdom or the governed territory means the power. Rashtrakuta dynasty extended from Vindhya to Kanyakumari. Their power was first established in Maharashtra by King Dantidurga. Krishnaraji first had the famous Kailas temple carved at Ellora. See students, up to now we have learnt about the different dynasties, yes or not, that ruled ancient India. And we took their information that how they expanded their empire. Students, now in next lesson, we will review the social and cultural life in ancient India. Students, some examples already I told you. Now I'm going to tell you about the periplus of the Eritrean Sea. A periplus is a handbook. The Eritrean Sea is the Red Sea. And for the Greeks, the Indian Ocean and the Persian Gulf were also part of a Red Sea. Periplus of the Eritrean Sea is a handbook of the Red Sea. And it was written sometime in the 1st century CE. The sailor who wrote it lived in Egypt. The periplus gives information about the trade that went on along the Indian coastline, the Persian Gulf and Egypt. Ports like Periksa, Pedoch, Nala Sopara, Kalyan, Muzairis are mentioned in the periplus. Muzairis was a port near Kochi in Kerala, and this ancient port does not exist any more. Okay, see students, now your homework on page number 47, exercise is given here, and you have to write all the question answers in your homework book. Okay, and read this lesson again and again. Thank you.